I believe the relationship of young people with 20th century and perhaps the 21st century music undoubtedly is closer compared to music of 17th or 18th century. Maybe subjects which surrounding us, tempo of our life is much faster, and rhythmical repercussions and effects of life, movement of the whole world in a different speed, it's much closer to young generation. That's why it's very interesting. When you're working on modern composition, you will find that some rhythmical difficulties can be much quicker accepted and adopted by young people compared to stylistic difficulties.
Thank you.
With the turn of the new millennium, the 20th century music becomes history. However, we shouldn't forget great contributions made by 20th century composers who simultaneously developing new musical forms and sound of the new orchestra. It's also very interesting that some composers created pieces dedicated to orchestra itself. A Young Person's Guide by Benjamin Britten has a very special role in that particular category. Britten wrote composition which not only perfectly describes every possible instrument of symphony orchestra, but he also made wonderful orchestration which gives a great excitement, particularly finale of the piece based on the fugue after Henry Purcell, gives such excitement and climax that nobody can react that without great affiliation with what's actually happening on the stage.
The Young Person's Guide to the Orchestra. The composer, Benjamin Britten, has written this piece of music specially to introduce you to the instruments of the orchestra. There are four teams of players: the strings, the woodwind, the brass, and the percussion. Each of these four teams uses instruments which have a family likeness. They make roughly the same kind of sound in the same way. The strings are played with a bow or plucked by the fingers. The woodwind are blown by the breath. The brass are blown as well. And the percussion are struck. First, you'll hear a theme by the great English composer Henry Purcell, played by the whole orchestra and by each one of the four groups of instruments. The recorder. They are made of wood. The first brass instruments were trumpets and hunting horns, and these are their modern descendants. The percussion group includes drums, gongs, tambourines, and anything else you can hit. When you have heard them, the whole orchestra will play the melody again. Let us hear each instrument play a variation of its own. The highest of the woodwind is the clear, sweet voice of the flute with its shrill little brother, the piccolo. ¶¶ Oboes have a gentle, plaintive quality, but they can be forceful enough when the composer wants them to. Clarinets are very agile. They make a beautifully smooth, mellow sound. Bassoons are the largest of the woodwind team, so they have the deepest voices. The highest voices in the string family are the violins. They play in two groups, firsts and seconds. Violas are a bit larger than violins, and so are deeper in tone. Cellos sing with splendid richness and warmth. Listen to this fine sound. double basses are the grandfathers of the string family with heavy, rumbling voices. The harp has 47 strings and 7 foot pedals to alter the pitch of its strings. The brass family begins with the horns. These are made from brass tubing coiled into a circle. I expect you all know the sound of the trumpets. The trombones have heavy, brassy voices. The bass tuba is heavier still. There is an enormous number of percussion instruments. We can't play them all, but here are the most familiar ones. First, the timpani, which used to be called kettle drums. The bass drum and cymbals. Tambourine and triangle. the side drum and Chinese block. The xylophone. The castanets and gong. And before they all play together, the whip. We've taken the whole orchestra to pieces. Now let's put it together in a fugue. The instruments come in one after another in the same order as before, beginning with the piccolo. At the end, the brass will play Henry Purcell's fine melody, while the others go on playing Benjamin Britten's fugue.